Hello and good morning, friends. Today, I want to talk to you about constant pressure systems. What are they? What do they look like? And which one's my favorite? So let's go ahead, take a look in this utility room, and let's get into it. All right, so we can see here that we have our constant pressure system set up. Now, in a traditional well tank situation, you're going to have your supply line in, just like this, right? You're going to have a big version of that, and you're not going to have any of these electronic bits, right? A traditional pressure tank is going to be the big blue thing in the basement with a T-assembly similar to that, where it's going to have a hose bib, pressure gauge, pressure relief valve, but instead of these, it'll have a pressure switch. So with the constant pressure system, the benefit of these is that you'll actually get more pressure throughout the entire house, and it's all because of the computer. This system works is as you call for water, so you turn on the kitchen sink, bathtub, whatever, the computer is going to tell the pump to increase its output or decrease its output depending on how much water you need. So with a conventional system, how the pressure in the home works is going to be based off of the pressure tank, right? So the big blue thing in the basement on a traditional system, generally in our area, will be a 40-60 switch. So what that means is at 40 PSI, the pump will turn on, it'll compress the air in the pressure tank until 60 PSI, and the pump will turn off. Now, what do I mean by that? On most pressure tank systems, right, modern ones, you might have a glass lined one from like the 1940s, but on modern pressure tank systems, you're gonna have air up top, a bladder in the middle, and water on the bottom, right? And so what'll happen is when the pressure drops to 40 PSI, you'll hear a click sound, the pump will engage, it will then pump water into the home, which will compress the air in the tank, and then that compressed air will pneumatically push the water through the home. Now, this system has a pressure tank, but we call it a buffer tank, right? So the little gray thing that we're looking at right here, this little fella is our buffer tank. So it's gonna be just a small version of a normal pressure tank where there's gonna be air up top, bladder in the middle, and water on the bottom. The sole purpose of this is so when the water's called for at the kitchen sink, bathtub, wherever, it doesn't just bottom out on you. This will kind of make it to where it'll turn on and give this enough time to engage. It's a computer, so it's very, very fast. So how this will work, you'll set the PSI over here. So we see that this one's set for 50 PSI. So what'll happen is this transducer will read the pressure in the pipe, and when the pipe pressure drops to 50 PSI, or drops below 50 PSI, this will engage. And so what'll look like is when we turn on our spigot, we'll see that immediately, as soon as we turn that on, the pump starts to engage. If we turn the water off, we'll see that the pump will continue to run for just a few more seconds, and then it will turn off. Systems are really, really efficient, and the benefit of having a constant pressure system is that we're normally on a well system with a traditional setup. The more water you start pulling, the more things you start calling for, the lower your pressure will get. For this one, basically you could take a shower, do the dishes, do the laundry, and theoretically you should have the same pressure throughout. The reason I say theoretically is it depends on the output of your well. So if you have a well that cannot yield a high enough volume of water, you will inherently have issues with the pressure, right? So that's why it's very important to make sure before you put one of these in, you look to see, do I have an adequate amount of reserve? And do I have an adequate amount of yield in the well? To determine an adequate amount of yield, you're gonna need to make sure you do one of two things. You either talk to the county, and they should have something on file to tell you, all right, this well's drilled at 200 feet, it's drilled at 10 gallons a minute, or it's drilled at 100 foot and it's drilled at 2 gallons a minute. The county should have something on file. At least in our state, every well is permitted, every well is required to be basically defined on the depth, the static, the gallons per minute, type of concrete they used, all that good stuff. You're supposed to document all of it, right? The other way you could do it is if you don't have anything on file, is you could hire somebody to do a yield test, which can either be done at the wellhead or in the home, depending on how the county approves it. So generally, when it comes to yields, I would usually recommend don't go below 4 gallons per minute. In our area, they calculate yield based off gallons per minute. And with these constant pressure systems, you need to have a good amount of water available in order for them to work. If you don't have enough water, it doesn't matter what pressure you want. It doesn't matter how fast you want that water to discharge. If you don't have enough water available, it's not going to do anything for you. So before you even start the conversation of pressure or constant pressure systems or any improvements to what you currently have, you need to make sure that you understand what is your well capable of doing. So this brand that I like the most is the Grundfos system. There's a variety of brands out there. that you can do constant pressure as well. I just like this one because it's very user-friendly for the homeowner to adjust or increase or decrease the pressure. It's also very, very simple for if something goes wrong, they can press a button and turn the pump off rather than having to go to the circuit panel or any other kind of switches. It's just a little bit easier for homeowners. Now you may be wondering, how much does something like this cost, right? Usually in our area, you'll see a constant pressure conversion cost anywhere from $2,000 to $3,000, but these systems will last basically the same amount of time. So you'll get roughly about 15 years, maybe 20, depending on what you're working with. And these systems run more efficiently. They're a little bit better quality. And once you put it in, the next time, all you're doing is just replacing the pump. Like, the biggest issue I see on these ones are the transducer. A couple $100 part, most homeowners can just swap those out on their own if that thing goes wrong. Usually how you'll tell is you just won't have any pressure, or you'll have very, very inconsistent pressure, and that's kind of counterintuitive for a constant pressure system. I know we covered a lot of ground, and I hope that you found this informative. If you did get any kind of value on this, if you think that this might be something you want to go towards, please leave a comment below. Tell me, are you thinking about a constant pressure system? If so, what kind of constant pressure system are you thinking of getting on your house? I recommend them to all homes that are 4 gallons a minute or above, just because it's really, really helpful, in my opinion, to have a better, more consistent pressure on a house. If you enjoy content like this, though, hit that like button, hit subscribe, and I look forward to talking to you guys tomorrow.